In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Declare his glory among the nations.
His marvelous deeds among all peoples.
Ascribe to the Lord, O families of nations.
Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength.
Worship the Lord in the splendor of his holiness.
Tremble before him all the earth.
Let the heavens rejoice, let the earth be glad. They will sing before the Lord, for he comes.
He comes to judge the earth.
He will judge the world in righteousness.
And the people sing his truth.
Church the true teachings of Scripture. Luther summarized those teachings in 5 short statements: by Scripture alone, by faith alone, through Christ alone, to God's glory alone, and by grace alone. These phrases form the foundation of the Lutheran Church, and because they are rooted in Scripture, they form the foundation of the Christian faith.
Thank you.
people prophecies, pictures of coming events, so they would recognize the Messiah when he came.
God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee,
you will be with child and give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever. His kingdom will never end.
How will this be? Mary asked the angel, since I am a virgin.
The angel answered, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who is said to be barren is in her sixth month, of the Bible's New Testament records the angel's instructions to Joseph concerning Mary's child. You are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins.
We have no part in saving ourselves. The Bible tells us we are saved through Christ alone. So we give God alone all the glory and thankfulness for sending his Son to save us. Yes, tonight we see a humble baby in a manger, but the Apostle Paul reminds us in his letter to the Philippians of Jesus' honored place. God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
Keeping watch over their flocks at night, an angel of the Lord appeared to them.
In the next few days, many of you will be opening your Christmas gifts. What did you do to earn those gifts? The moment we do something to earn them, they are no longer gifts. Out of love for us, God gave the most precious gift on that first Christmas night, the Savior, who lived a perfect life and suffered and died to pay for our sins.
Our sinful nature wants nothing to do with God and His precious gift. Despite that fact, God loves us still. God's love is undeserved. That is grace. The Apostle Paul reminds us,
for it is by grace you have been saved, through faith, and this not from yourselves. It is the gift of God, not by works, so that no one can boast.
After you have opened your gifts, do you keep quiet about them, or do you tell all your friends what you have received? When the shepherds saw God's gift to the world, they did not keep the news to themselves. They spread the word so that others could experience God's grace too.
When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in a manger. When they
God, our wonderful counselor, in your word you reveal to us who you are and what we are. Mighty God, you provide us with certain hope and redeem us from our sin.
Through faith alone, we hold to your promises, and through Christ alone, we receive salvation.
Everlasting Father, you rule the universe, the church, and the hearts of your people.
To you alone belongs all glory and praise.
Prince of Peace, your love covers us and fills us and moves us.
Your grace alone receives new life and eternal hope.
Faithful God, move us to rejoice in our salvation and to share eagerly this good news with others. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look on you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Good evening. Welcome to all of you. I think the final words of that last hymn say it all. To God be the glory. And that's what we say. We thank God for all that he has done for us. I'm grateful to God that he's brought you here, especially our visitors who are here with us. It's been a pleasure to be able to worship with you. And thank you also for sharing your children that here they might share that blessed news of our Savior who was born for us. Take the bulletin home with you, not only as a memorial of the wonderful word that you heard here today, but also in there is printed our worship schedule for the next 2 weeks with Christmas and New Year. Please note especially the special worship time next Sunday. We won't have worship at 8 and 10:30 like we usually do. Just one service in the morning at 9:30. That will be our children's Sunday school service. And then our Christmas Eve services in the evening at their regular times, 4 and 6:30. May God richly bless your worship and your meditation on this precious gift that God gives to us this Christmas.